I don't really even know what I'm doing with this thing. We are back for another chapter of the Book of Matthew. This is chapter 24, and you are watching the Bible Vlog. Okay, so chapter 24 is really broken down into kind of three different parts. So the first is about the description of the temple in Jerusalem. The next part is about Jesus' second coming, and then the third is about the end times. Now the difficult part with Jesus' teaching here is that all three of these are kind of interwoven together, so it can make it a little difficult to determine which event is actually being described by Jesus. Now something to keep in mind about prophecy in the Bible is that there's usually a near and then a remote fulfillment. In other words, one prophecy can be used to point to two different events. So for example, Jesus talks about some of the horrible things that would be happening around the time that the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. But he also uses these same conditions to describe what the earth will be like before his second coming. Okay, so there is a ton to look at here, but let's go ahead and start in verses 1 and 2. Then Jesus went out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came up to show him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said to them, "Do you not see all these things? Assuredly I say to you, not one stone shall be left here upon another that shall not be thrown down." Now, something interesting I want to point out here is a literal fulfillment of this prophecy that Jesus just stated. When he said that not one stone would be left on top of another, that was truly what happened. So we know that in 70 AD, the Jews started revolting against the Roman Empire and Jerusalem was raided. Now, during the fighting, the temple was set on fire, and although nobody is exactly certain how it happened, Josephus, who was a Jewish historian at the time, wrote that a firebrand or maybe some kind of torch was thrown through a window. Now the fire caught on to the entire temple and everything in it was destroyed. Now there's some debate on why the Romans exactly ripped the temple apart, as we know they did, but what many people believe is that during the fire, much of the gold that was inside of the temple melted and then went down between the rocks. The Romans then ripped apart the temple stone by stone, trying to get to the base of it to retrieve the gold. So this literally fulfilled Jesus' prophecy about not one stone being left on top of another. It's crazy stuff, isn't it? All right, now continuing reading, Jesus sits down and tells his disciples what the signs will be of his second coming. So when we refer to the second coming of Jesus, what we're talking about is that after Jesus was raised from the dead, he ascended into heaven. Now his disciples actually watched him go up. This whole thing is documented in the Gospels, but the Bible says that Jesus is going to come back in the same way he left, and that we will see him returning in the clouds. Now this is a longer section of scripture, but really insightful, so let's go ahead and read verses 3 through 14. Now as he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately saying, "Tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age?" And Jesus answered and said to them, "Take heed that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines, pestilences, and earthquakes in various places."
Sounds a lot like today, doesn't it?
All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you, and you will be hated by all nation for my name's sake. And then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another. Then many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. And because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold, but he who endures to the end shall be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as a witness to all the nations, and then the end will come.
That pretty much describes today's world, doesn't it?
Now, this is why so many Christians, including myself, believe that Jesus is coming back very, very soon. Now, the one other thing to keep in mind whenever we talk about Jesus coming back is that no one knows when it will happen. Now, over the years, people have tried to make all kinds of predictions on when Jesus would return. Let me be the first to tell you that if you do this, you're really wasting your time. No one knows. Look over at verse 36 with what Jesus himself said. "But of that day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only." So Jesus is literally saying that even at that moment, in his incarnate state where he is fully human, even he didn't know the time himself. The point being this, guys, I have seen so many people over time get all wrapped up in studies of the end times. Now, yes, I do think we should be aware that Jesus is returning soon, and I think we need to tell as many people as possible about coming to know him, but don't get wrapped up in trying to guess impossible dates. Instead, focus on the fact that even though we don't know the exact time of Jesus' return, we know he is coming soon. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that is it for us today with chapter 24. Now, there is a ton more in this chapter that we didn't have time to fully cover in this vlog. That's why I'm always so adamant that you make sure you're reading it for yourself. All right, guys, hope you all have a wonderful day. Thank you, as always, for joining us. Tomorrow is chapter 25, and then just 3 more to go to the end of the book. All right, I love your faces. Hope you all have a beautiful day, and I will see you back here tomorrow.